Welcome back. Chief Minister Jayalalitha brought cheer to the farmers by announcing an increase in the duration of the three-phase power supply for motor pumps in the Delta region from 9 to 12 hours to facilitate their taking up the Kurubai cultivation. Farmers expressed their gratitude as this would ensure that the short-term paddy crop will be raised over 1.5 lakh acres. As per the new arrangement, power would be ensured for 8 hours in the day and 4 hours at night.
Parliamentary Standing Committee on Home Affairs. So he wanted to meet me.
விவசாயிகள் வந்து சாகுபடி பண்ண முடியுமோ, குருவை நடுவோமா நட வேண்டாமாங்கிற ஒரு டவுட்லேயே இருந்துட்டு இருந்தோம். ஆனால் வந்து இப்போ நேற்று வந்து முதல்வர் அவர்கள் வந்து மூணை மின்சாரம் வந்து விவசாயத்துக்கு 12 மணி நேரம் வழங்குறோம் அப்படின்னு அறிவிச்சிருக்காங்க. அது எங்களுக்கு வந்து மகிழ்ச்சியை தரக்கூடிய செய்திகள் தான். ஆனால் வந்து இந்த அவங்க அறிவித்தது வந்து முழுமையாக செயலில் வந்து அவங்க செயல்படுத்தணும். அப்படி இருந்தால் தான் நாங்கள் வந்து இப்போ விவசாய பணிகளை வந்து நம்பி நாங்கள் செய்ய முடியும்.
சென்ற ஆண்டு 40,000 ஹெக்டேர் வரை சாகுபடி மேற்கொள்ளப்பட்டது. மேட்டூர் அணை காலத்தோடு திறக்கப்பட்டதால் இந்த ஆண்டு தமிழக முதல்வர்கள் எப்படியாவது குருவை பயிரிட வேண்டும்ங்கிற எண்ணத்திலே ஒரு அறிவிப்பை வெளியிட்டிருக்கிறார்கள். நாங்கள் வரவேற்கிறோம். கூடுதலாக மின்சாரம் வழங்கப்படும், அதற்கான தனி நிதி ஒதுக்கப்படும் என்ற மின்சார வாரியத்தை கேட்டிருப்பதை நாங்கள் வரவேற்கிறோம்.
Tamilnadu School Education Minister N.R. Sivapathi flagged off the buses carrying 50 couples along with their relatives who will be blessing the couples in the mass marriage of 1,006 couples to be solemnized by Chief Minister Jayalalitha at the Sri Kumari Amman Temple near Chennai. Former Minister M. Paranjyothi, District Collector Mrs. Jayashri Muralidharan, City Corporation Mayor Mrs. Ajaya and others participated in the flagging off function. The train service from Tirupati to Madurai is all set to be extended to Rameshwaram. After inspecting the Rameshwaram railway station, Southern Railways manager A.K. Mittal announced that steps are being taken to set up the service very soon. He also stated that there will be one passenger rail extra in the mornings for the Madurai-Rameshwaram route. He added that the Southern Railway has a lot of celebrations planned for the 100th year of the Pamban Bridge in 2014. Moving on, at least 3 security personnel at the Central Reserve Police Force got injured in a grenade attack in Sopore of Jammu and Kashmir. Militants reportedly hurled a grenade at a picket of CRPF, after which one security official is said to be in critical condition. The injured have been shifted to a local hospital, following which the attack site was cordoned off for search operations. So far, no militant organization has claimed responsibility for the attack. It's a crucial day for Europe as all eyes are on Greece after the general elections held in the country last month failed to form a government. The crisis-ridden country is going through a snap election now among worries that if Greece quits the euro, it will plunge the continent into a deep crisis. All financial aid from Europe has been put on hold until the political situation gets more stable. The Greek government will run out of cash within a few days, and the austerity measures the country is expected to adopt are the toughest any developed country will face. While Greece is voting one of the most critical elections in recent memory, European and other leaders are gathering at the G20 summit in Mexico to discuss ways of keeping the country and the European Union intact. President Philippe Calderon inaugurated the ceremony. Relief for Greece and other impacted European countries like Spain and Italy has become the main topic of discussion. The owners of 300 Bangladesh garments factories shut their operations indefinitely yesterday after days of violent wage protests by workers, threatening the country's biggest export already impacted by the global downturn. The decision to close all factories at Ashulia, one of the country's biggest industrial zones on the outskirts of Dhaka, came as talks between workers and owners failed to break the deadlock. Witnesses said that the police fired tear gas and rubber bullets and used water cannons to disperse rampaging workers during the 5 days of clash. About 250 people, including police, have been injured and activists have vandalized dozens of vehicles and barricaded a vital highway. Thousands of visitors thronged an exhibition train spreading awareness about HIV and AIDS in Visakhapatnam yesterday. The Red Ribbon Express is a special train that travels across the country to spread awareness on the disease and will halt at 162 stations during its year-long journey across 23 states.
Hmm.
It's another short break for now. We'll be right back.